After what he said, I don't know what to say. He said everything. What he said, I'm taking the same. Yeah, the same.
Well, it was a big win for you tonight. What are the emotions like right now?
Yeah, it's too much to win in the Madison Square Garden. For me, it's too much. In my age, you know, I'm old. So for me, it's great.
A lot gets made of that, of your age, you know. How do you feel in there? I mean, do you feel like this is something you can continue doing for a while? Or do you look at everyone as like, this might be it?
I'm saying everyone, I'm saying maybe this is the one, but no, I continue. I don't feel old. I don't feel the body. I'm feeling good. I did 12 surgeries in my body, and I still feel good, you know. I want to dedicate this fight also to a friend of mine that died from cancer 2 weeks ago. So, Shani, this is for you. And that's it.
How did the fight play out versus what you expected in there tonight?
That was my plan, to go to the ground on my back, because I came from the jiu-jitsu. I can fight from my back, I don't care. And everything was good. I don't remember how I get to the ground, what happened over there, but I remember that I walk on the triangle all the time, taking his risk and like play with it until I got the triangle. I couldn't get the choke right, so I with the elbow, a little bit of elbow and stuff and punches, and then the choke.
Yeah. You've been around for a long time, but tonight was special. I mean, to be fighting in Madison Square Garden, did it mean something special to you?
Yeah, yeah. To win over here. Last time I was over here, I lost to Ryan Couture. So I never thought I'm going to get another chance to fight over here, but I got it. And for me, it was, I have to win, you know. It's not the first time it was just to fight over here, but now it was just to win over here.
So what do you want to do moving forward? I mean, do you want to keep competing? I know they like using you in Israel. Do you want to keep like fighting there? Do you like traveling abroad? Do you want to fight with your son on cards or no?
I'm going to fight until my body's going to quit. That's for sure. And I'm producing also the Israeli show. So in Israel, it's a big show. It's like 9,000 people every show. It's crazy over there. It's become like let's say soccer, basketball. It's become like the third sport in Israel, you know. It's like the only sport in Israel that bring like 9,000 people to arena.
Can you talk a little bit about the Israeli style of fighting? Is there anything different, anything special that comes from the way they train martial arts there and the way they've adapted MMA?
It's almost the same, but we don't have a lot of professional fighters, so that's why the level over there of the fighters is not too much. We build it. So for this camp, I start to train over in New York, also with Henzo, my master, like more than 20 years. And also I mix like Krav Maga a little bit in the training. It's new. We start like to taking like technique from Krav Maga and mix it with the MMA and the Jiu-Jitsu. I don't remember the fight, so I don't know if I got it good, but I'm gonna watch the video.
Well, the biggest thing that I noted from getting the triangle was your level of patience. You were just waiting and waiting until you can get that wrist control. Did you notice that he, you know, was changing levels to try to get that, to change that attack for you?
Yeah, that's a game that I'm playing all the time with the hand. I'm playing with the hand, like the guys like start to think is like it can go up, can go down, and then I'm getting the triangle. But I didn't get it good, so that's why it took me long to choke him. And so I heard somebody said like 1 minute, 2 minutes. So I said, oh my God, not the second round again. Because every time I'm passing the first round, it's a 3-round fight. So, and he submitted at the end.
Yeah,